In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Beloved in the Lord, let us draw near with a true heart and confess our sins unto God our Father, beseeching him in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ to grant us forgiveness. Our help is in the name of the Lord. I said I will confess my transgressions unto the Lord. Almighty God, our Maker and Redeemer, we poor sinners confess unto thee that we are by nature sinful and unclean, and that we have sinned against thee by thought, word, and deed. Wherefore we flee for refuge to thine infinite mercy, seeking and imploring thy grace for the sake of our Lord Jesus Christ. O most merciful God, who hast given thine only begotten Son to die for us, have mercy upon us, and for his sake grant us remission of all our sins, and by thy Holy Spirit increase in us true knowledge of thee, and of thy will, and true obedience to thy word, to the end that by thy grace we may come to everlasting life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, hath had mercy upon us, and hath given his only Son to die for us, and for his sake forgiveth us all our sins. To them that believe in his name he giveth power to become sons of God, and hath promised them his Holy Spirit. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. Grant this, Lord, unto us all.
Like newborn infants, long for the pure spiritual milk, that by it you may grow up to salvation.
If indeed you have tasted that the Lord is good.
O give thanks to the Lord, call upon his name.
Make known his deeds among the peoples.
Sing to him, sing praises to him.
Tell all his wondrous works.
Glory in his holy name.
Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice.
Seek the Lord and his strength.
Seek his presence continually.
Remember the wondrous works that he has done,
his miracles and judgments he uttered.
He remembers his covenant forever,
the word that he commanded for a thousand generations.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Like newborn infants, long for the pure spiritual milk, that by it you may grow up to salvation.
If indeed you have tasted that the Lord is good.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, grant that we who have celebrated the Lord's resurrection may by your grace confess in our life and conversation that Jesus is Lord and God, through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. The first reading for the second Sunday of Easter is from Acts chapter 5. But Peter and the apostles answered, "We must obey God rather than man. The God of our fathers raised Jesus, whom you killed by hanging him on a tree. God exalted him at his right hand as leader and savior, to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sins. And we are witnesses to these things, and so is the Holy Spirit, whom God has given to those who obey him." When they heard this, they were enraged and wanted to kill them. But a Pharisee in the council named Gamaliel, a teacher of the law held in honor by all the people, stood up and gave orders to put the men outside for a little while. And he said to them, "Men of Israel, take care of what you are about to do with these men. For before these days, Theudas rose up, claiming to be somebody, and a number of men, about 400, joined him. He was killed, and all who followed him were dispersed and came to nothing. After him, Judas the Galilean rose up in the days of the census and drew away some of the people after him. He too perished. And all who followed him were scattered. So in the present case, I tell you, keep away from these men and let them alone. For if this plan or this undertaking is of man, it will fail. But if it is of God, you will not be able to overthrow them. You might even be found opposing God." So they took his advice, and when they had called in the apostles, they beat them and charged them not to speak in the name of Jesus, and let them go. Then they left the presence of the council, rejoicing that they were counted worthy to suffer dishonor for the name. And every day in the temple and from house to house, they did not cease teaching and preaching Jesus as the Christ. This is the word of the Lord. The epistle is from 1 Peter chapter 1. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus the Christ. According to his great mercy, he has caused us to be born again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you, who by God's power are being guarded through faith, for a salvation ready to be revealed in the last time. In this you rejoice, though now for a little while, if necessary, you have been grieved by various trials, so that the tested genuineness of your faith, more precious than gold that perishes through it is tested by fire, may be found to result in praise and glory and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Though you have not seen him, you love him. Though you do not now see him, you believe in him, and rejoice with joy that is inexpressible and filled with glory, obtaining the outcome of your faith, the salvation of your souls. This is the word of the Lord. Christ has risen from the dead.
God the Father has crowned him with glory and honor.
He has given him dominion over the works of his hands.
He has put all things under his feet.
Amen. Holy Gospel is according to St. John, the 20th chapter. On the evening of that day, the first day of the week, the doors being locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples were glad when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, even so I am sending you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of anyone, they are forgiven. If you withhold forgiveness from anyone, it is withheld." Now Thomas, one of the 12, called the twin, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see in his hands the mark of the nails, and place my finger into the mark of the nails, and place my hand into his side, I will never believe." 8 days later, his disciples were inside again, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were locked, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and put out your hand and place it in my side. Do not disbelieve, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of the disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that by believing, you may have life in his name. Here endeth the gospel.
I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. He is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
And our faith is built on nothing less. But on that first Easter evening, the disciples, the apostles, lacked such faith. Sure, Jesus had prophesied that he would rise, saying, "The Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men and be crucified, and on the third day rise." Sure, the tomb was empty. Sure, Peter and John had seen it was so. And of course, the women, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary, had also seen the empty tomb. And what's more, when they had gone with their burial spices to finish preparing the body of Jesus, which they could not do before because of the Passover feast, they arrived and the tomb was empty. But that was not all. They were greeted by men with an appearance like lightning and clothes white as snow. Unmistakably, they were angels. They were so furiously holy that for fear of them, the guards trembled and became like dead men. The angels announced to them, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you seek Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has risen." And then the women actually encountered the risen Christ. Jesus said, "Rejoice." And they came up and took hold of his feet and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me." And the women did go. They went and they told the disciples. They were the first to proclaim that they had seen the risen Christ. They were the first eyewitnesses of the resurrection. Yet the disciples still didn't believe. Sure, the women said they had seen the risen Christ, but you know women. They're emotional. Jesus had just been crucified. Can you really blame them for being so hysterical? Who has ever heard of such a thing, that a man rises himself from the dead? Jesus was not the first to come claiming that he was the Messiah. Others had come and gained followers for themselves, as Gamaliel the Pharisee testified. Gamaliel was a teacher of the law, held in honor by all people, and he gave wise and sage advice, saying, "Before these days, Theudas rose up, claiming to be somebody, and a number of men, about 400, joined him. He was killed, and all who followed him were dispersed and came to nothing. After him, Judas the Galilean rose up in the days of the census and drew away some people after him. He too perished, and all who had followed him were scattered. So in the present case, I tell you, keep away from these men and let them alone, for if the plan or this undertaking is of man, it will fail. But if it is of God, you will not be able to overthrow them. You might even be found opposing God." And so the disciples were there on that first Easter. On the evening of that day, the first day of the week, the doors being locked for fear of the Jews. It was the first Easter, the day of the resurrection, and the disciples were behind locked doors in fear. They did not believe. When they should have been rejoicing that the tomb was empty and the witness of the women, they instead huddled in fear. It was evening, and it looked to them in the darkness of their souls that the light they had thought had come into the world had set. That darkness had indeed overcome him. They thought that Jesus had gone the way of Theudas and Judas, that he was dead. And they were all but ready to disperse. Perhaps in a few days when all had blown away, blown over, when they thought it would be safe for them to leave the city and return to the countryside. Indeed, what Gamaliel said is true. If this undertaking is of man, it will fail. But if it is of God, you will not be able to overthrow them. You might even be found opposing God. The disciples were in no place to carry on the message of a dead Messiah. But dear brothers and sisters, this undertaking was not of man. It was the undertaking of God. It was the missio Dei, the mission of God, to come into the world and to conquer sin, death, and the devil through his incarnation, through his crucifixion, and through his resurrection. His cross and spilt blood were not his defeat, but the very purpose of his coming. They were the payment rendered unto the Father for the guilt of the world. And the resurrection is the sure sign that the check cleared. These things were not defeat, but God's great mercy, by which he has caused us to be born again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for us now, while we still live our earthly life, and which will be ours when we die and are raised on the last day. In the resurrection, there can be no doubt that God was behind this, as Peter would soon proclaim on Pentecost. This Jesus God raised up, and of that we are all witnesses. Let all the house of Israel therefore know for certain that God has made him both Lord and Christ, this Jesus whom you crucified. Theudas and Judas are dead. Siddhartha and Muhammad are dead. But he is risen. And so the disciples huddled in fear. They sit in darkness, in the darkness of despair and unbelief. But he is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
But they do not yet believe it. And here is the thing about belief. It doesn't actually change reality itself. They do not believe it, and yet whether they believe it or not, Christ is risen. Whether they believe it or not, he is already Lord and Christ. And the risen Savior came and stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." This peace that he gives is not merely a greeting. It is not a holy howdy. But it is the peace that comes from his cross. He showed them his hands and his side. He showed them the wounds of the nails in his hands, and he showed them the spot in his side where the spear had pierced him and pierced his heart. He showed them the things that made for peace. His wounds that reconciled God and man, and he proclaims that peace to his disciples. With his word, he gives it to them. He bestows it upon them. They are no longer unbelieving, but believing. And so they are filled with joy. He is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
And our faith is built on nothing less. Upon showing them the marks of his passion that he bore on his body, Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, even so I am sending you." Just as Christ came to reveal the Father, to speak the words of the Father, to do the works of the Father, he now sends his apostles and ministers into the world in his stead and by his command. He sends them out to speak his word, to do his works, and to reveal him. And the message that he brought with him, peace be with you. Your sins are forgiven. The peace of God be with you. He now places on the lips of his disciples. By the power of his death and resurrection, sin has been defeated, and peace with God has been obtained. Now the authority to proclaim that peace, the power to declare that peace, is given to the church and her ministers. That word of forgiveness, that declaration of God, that justification is put into their mouths by Christ. Christ says, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you withhold forgiveness from any, it is withheld." There is one missing from that assembly of the 12, besides Judas the betrayer, a certain Thomas called Didymus, who the Gospels paint as being only second in boldness to Peter. Thomas, too, would not believe, even with the testimony of the 10 added to the testimony of the women. Yet as one of the 12, he had a specific calling. He had a calling to be a witness to Jesus' resurrection so that he could proclaim what he had seen. And so Jesus appears again through locked doors, his body glorified, so united with his divine nature, so that his human nature is no longer bound by space and location as we are. He appears again in their midst and proclaims the same peace to Thomas that he had proclaimed to the disciples. And he bids him, put your finger here and see my hands, and put out your hands and place it in my side. Do not disbelieve, but believe. And upon encountering the risen Lord, Thomas confesses what he knows to be undoubtedly true, that Jesus is risen and that he is Lord and God. Soon the apostles, knowing that Christ was indeed risen, no longer hide in fear. It has changed them. It changes everything about them. What was there to fear if Christ had conquered death? What could the Jews or Romans take away that God could not give back infinitely more? Indeed, what could the fallen world do to them? Whether it be persecution or natural disaster or disease, or even death. All of these things have been overcome in Christ. They now understood what Jesus had taught them that day of the triumphal entry. He who loves his life loses it, and he who hates his life in this world will keep it to life eternal. And so when the Sanhedrin commanded them to be silent about Jesus, Peter and the apostles answered, we must obey God rather than men. They no longer feared the Jews nor the Romans. The God of our fathers raised Jesus, whom you killed by hanging him on a tree. God exalted him at his right hand as leader and savior to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sins. And we are witnesses to these things. And so is the Holy Spirit, whom God has given to those who obey him. And these things have been written, they have happened for one purpose, that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that by believing in his name, you may have eternal life. He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Hallelujah. Peace be with you. Amen. You may rise for the offertory. Let us pray for the whole Church of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. O God, our Father, you have raised your Son and he has bestowed the Holy Spirit on his apostles. Believing Christ's resurrection, help us also to trust the forgiving words of his servants. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
O God, our Father, turn the enemies of your church and bring their hearts to repentance. Strengthen all Christians in their faith and in their vocation of service as your children, that we may be obedient to your word and receive the salvation of our souls. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
O God, our Father, build up the households of your people, that your holy children, begotten in baptism, may grow in your grace and share together in your forgiveness and life. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
O God, our Father, you establish rulers and officials for the sake of order and peace. Bless those who have been placed in authority in federal, state, and local governments. Give them the desire to serve with integrity and honor to work for the benefit of all. Grant also integrity, honor, and bravery to those who serve in our armed forces, such as Sean, Austin, and Thomas. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
O God, our Father, we praise your Son's resurrection from the dead and draw strength from his ascension before you, where he ever stands for us as our own high priest. Show your kindness to Amy, Mary, Harold, Prabhu, Jordan, Aubrey, Barbara, Charlotte, Maya, Wanda, Kenny, and Patricia. We also pray that you comfort the family of Tony, who has been received into glory. Graciously receive our prayers of intercession for Christ's sake. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our
prayer. O God, our Father, your Son greets his disciples with peace despite their sins against him. Make us confident in his mercy towards us and glad in our hearts as he comes to us in his body and blood with forgiveness and renewal whenever we celebrate the supper. Lord, in your mercy. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we thank you that of your indescribable grace, for the sake of your Son, you have given us the Holy Gospel and instituted the blessed sacraments, that through them we may have comfort and forgiveness of sin. Grant us your Holy Spirit, that we may heartily believe your word, and through the holy sacraments establish our faith day by day, until at last we obtain eternal salvation. Through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Blessed Lord, who hast caused all holy scriptures to be written for our learning, grant that we may in such wise hear them, read, mark, learn, and inwardly digest them, that by patience and comfort of thy holy word, we may embrace and ever hold fast the blessed hope of everlasting life, which thou hast given us in our Savior Jesus Christ, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end. The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace. Thank you. Okay, we have quite a few announcements for you guys this morning. First off, before I forget, if you ordered Easter lilies, please come pick them up today. This is the last chance to get those. If you forgot what you ordered, the order form should be up in the front pew somewhere. Ladies' Aid will be meeting this Tuesday at 7 p.m. And also, we have the Zone Rally with the details in the bulletin coming up this Saturday. I am now the Ladies' Aid, the LWML Rally Counselor or Zone Counselor as of this last Tuesday, so I will be there as well to lead you guys in Bible study, and I hope to see many of you ladies there as well, that Zion has a good showing at the Zone Rally. CWS picnic will be on the 26th from 6 to 7:15, which leads us to the even more important news that next Sunday will be Confirmation Sunday, so please make sure that you are here to rejoice with our new confirmands as they are confirmed and confess their faith before God and man, and also they take the Lord's Supper for the first time. And then the Saturday before that at 3 p.m., so a very busy Saturday, this upcoming Saturday, at 3 p.m. they will have their recitation. They are studying hard, they are learning their catechism, and all of you are invited to be here and see them recite what they have learned for you at 3 p.m. So friends and family and anyone else in the congregation is also invited to that. Also in LWML News, the National Convention is approaching. And finally, the fire department, if all has gone according to plan, should be outside for pictures to give us thanks for the donation we made from the proceeds of the fish fry. So there should be some fire trucks out there, so bring the kids, and that'll be fun. And we're happy to donate to them, and they are certainly grateful for that as well. Any important announcements that I have missed? Okay. Depart in peace.